guys, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about my daughter's second grade curriculum that I will be using for her. Let's go ahead and get right into it. So the first thing that I have here is this journal. This journal is from the Food Anatomy, Nature Anatomy, Ocean Anatomy books by Julia Rothman. And this is how it looks on the first page. So for science, we are going to be finishing up our Genesis curriculum that I talked about in another video that I just did. And we're also going to be doing this nature journal. So I'm really excited about that. I'll be doing it alongside her because she doesn't know exactly how to, you know, write paragraphs and stuff like that. And the journal is, you know, it's a lot of writing, drawing, like a nature study journal. And it's really beautiful. It's divided into four seasons: fall, spring, summer, winter. And this is the summer section. So it's just a really beautiful journal that I'm really excited to be doing with her. I have all the nature anatomy books, and we will be using those along with this journal. Just on days when I feel like she needs a little bit more age-appropriate science, because the Genesis curriculum, which I have here as well, the Genesis curriculum is for K through 8th. So sometimes the topics are a little bit like out of range for her, but I feel like if we could do this journal alongside Genesis and maybe look into our anatomy books, look into our anatomy books when it pertains to a certain topic that Genesis is also talking about, and have her do something in here for it, I feel like the information will stick with her better. She is only going into second grade, so it's not a big deal. We're not taking it too serious yet, but I do think that this will be really fun. So that's what we're going to be doing for science. Moving on to math. This is the EP Math 1 workbook, which I also reviewed in one of my other videos. We are going to be continuing with Easy Peasy. I was thinking about, you know, trying something else out, but like the old saying goes, if it's not broken, don't fix it. And I just feel like Easy Peasy was really easy for my daughter to just do. And I'm going to be continuing with Easy Peasy, but I'm going to be doing their online math program. And the reason that I'm going to be doing their online math program is because the online math program has a lot of games and fun activities that the workbook doesn't. So I feel like using the Easy Peasy math workbook too alongside the online material will be a stronger math program. Because like I told you guys in my review video, I did have to sometimes supplement because I felt like she needed more practice. And if I can do the Easy Peasy Math 2 workbook and the online version as well, then she can go ahead and do the work in the workbook for that day and then log on to Easy Peasy and play the games, which would reinforce everything that we just learned. So that's what she's gonna be doing with math. We are finished with this workbook, so she will be moving into Easy Peasy Math 2. Next subject that we're gonna be working on is language arts. And we are continuing with level K. She is on unit 4 right now, so we should be done with level K in about 2 months or so, I would say, maybe 3 months. And then I'm going to go ahead and buy or print the level 1 language arts from The Good and the Beautiful. So we are going to be continuing with The Good and the Beautiful language arts because I just feel that it's such a thorough program, and it has some beautiful books, beautiful stories, and I just love the way that it's laid out. So we're going to be continuing with The Good and the Beautiful for language arts. Something new that we're going to be adding this year is Explode the Code. So I've never used this curriculum, but I see that it's really highly recommended, and we are going to be doing it. It seems like it's really, really easy. It's just like a worksheet. It's just like a worksheet or two a day. So we're gonna be doing this. We're gonna be starting with number one, simply because, like I said, we've never done this program, so I want her to start from the beginning. And I do have all the books all the way up to 4, I believe. So we're gonna be doing Explode the Code 1 and 1.5. And then if she finishes these two, then we can move on to 2 and keep going from there. For second grade history, we are going to be using Genesis curriculum still. I told you guys in my review video that I do love this curriculum a lot because it's discussion based. So we're gonna be continuing this curriculum. Like you guys, as you guys can see, we're a little over halfway through. We're on lesson, I believe 100, and there's only 140 lessons in this book. So we should probably be done with the Genesis curriculum halfway through our school year. And from there on, we are going to be doing Beautiful Feet books. We're gonna be doing Teaching Virtues and probably Around the World. And we're gonna be using that for the second half of our homeschool year. So once we're done with Genesis curriculum, we're gonna be moving on to that. And I don't know if we're gonna continue with the Genesis curriculum. I really, really want to continue, but I also really want to teach history and social studies through like a literature-based curriculum. Simply because I've just been reading so much about it, and I feel like it's a beautiful way for children to learn just by reading good books, you know, books that teach a lesson, virtues, morals, things like that. And so that's why I'm kind of on the fence of if we're gonna continue with Genesis or not. But we are going to do Beautiful Feet books the second half of our school year. So I'm excited to see how that goes and see if it's a good fit for us. And I guess from that moment on, we'll determine whether we're going to continue with the Genesis curriculum, the book that comes after the book of Genesis, which would be, I think, Exodus, or if we're going to be doing Beautiful Feet books from now on. So we'll see what happens. My son is in eighth grade also. He's gonna be going into eighth grade. So this book is only recommended from K through 8. So I will have to figure out what he's gonna do, but I'm gonna be doing a whole separate video on his curriculum and what I'm gonna be using for his eighth grade school year. I also have this little thing over here hanging around, and this is a fun schooling book. It's called the seven Subject Portfolio. I just love how it looks. I think we might do some of the stuff in here simply because my daughter really loves Minecraft. And this is Minecraft in the real world 7 subject portfolio. So you do a little bit of everything in here. You do science, geography, so many things. But I'm not sure if it's, you know, like her level yet. I mean, I'm guessing we can make it her level because it's just a journal, we fill it in. I think this would be fun to do alongside our other nature journal. I was gonna say fun schooling, but this isn't fun schooling. This is just a nature journal. So we'll see what happens. I'm not too sure, you know, what we're gonna do. I got it only because it's Minecraft. And so we'll see what happens. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. If you guys are using any of this curriculum, let me know what you guys think about it. I'm also going to be doing another video talking about what I do for my kids for enrichment. So if you guys are interested in seeing what we're gonna be using for this upcoming school year for their enrichment classes, then please subscribe to my channel so you guys could be notified when that video comes out. Thank you so much again, and I'll see you guys in the next one.